Great. Welcome to our play, The Choice is Yours, Perry Dream, Ms. Milk's class. This play is great. We've been working on it for so long. We have like Adam Sandler in here, Michael Jackson, Michael Jordan. I mean, we have like the best. No, I'm just kidding, guys. I'm supposed to laugh. God, it wasn't funny. Okay, this is an English murder mystery, and Detective Woolrich is going to need your help to solve the mystery. So without further ado, let's start the play.
Solve the mystery.
Murder can be such a nuisance. Oh, there you are. I don't know who done me in, as they used to say in British mystery thrillers, but I won't sleep easy in my coffin until I find out. That's where you all come in. I'll need your help.
Sure.
If you don't mind, Mr. Forrest, I already started this investigation.
Only trying to help.
Leave it to professional. Besides, you're dead. Beat it.
Call me if you need me.
I'll do that. Name's Woolrich. Detective Woolrich. Homicide. I'm the investigator in charge. A murder has just taken place on the stage of a local community theater. You've already met the stiff. Pardon, I meant to say the victim. It's me you're assisting, not him. Murder took place 3 days ago during the rehearsal of some dumb play. Just so you'll understand, I'll stop the action every once in a while, and you can tell me how I should proceed. We work together. Got that? Okay. Okay. Good. I already gave you the scene of the crime. Time was early evening. No wounds on the body. What we need are suspects.
Phyllis Love, I was an actress in that dumb play, Leading Lady. Audrey Thaxter, another actress. I used to play the sweet young thing.
Paul Westfield, actor.
Jeanette Marsh, exceptionally talented director.
Barbara Lloyd, stage manager and prop.
Dolly Brand, part-time cleaning woman. I only do it to pass the time. I don't need the job. I've got plenty of money set aside. I like to feel useful.
Like the stiff? The victim wanted to know who done it. Okay, so what have we got? The scene of the crime, the approximate time, suspects. What else should we be looking for? Motive or how the murder was committed?
Motive!
Motive it is. Let's hear some motives.
I had an excellent motive. Gordon Forrest is blasphemy. I come from a very wealthy, socially prominent family. For diploma, I feel the rich and highly respected. But he knew I was a kleptomaniac. That's right. I still think, not because I need the things or even want them. It's almost like psychiatry. Gordon threatened to tell the media unless I paid off. The scandal destroyed my family and ruined my reputation. Did I kill him or not?
I'm not surprised Gordon turned out to be a blackmailer. He was the bad sort, but oh, so charming and hard to resist. We were getting married, or at least that's what people thought. The wedding invitations were already in the mail, and he just dumped me. You can imagine how awful it would be if I had to tell guests the wedding was off. I'm glad he's dead. I don't know how I'd tell everyone the truth that I was dumped. Did poor, penniless Audrey kill or not? You decide.
You've heard of poor, I'm sure. An actor would kill for a good part. Community theater is my life. It's all I live for. Gordon Forrest always got the good roles, the best lines. I should have gotten that role in that dumb play, but I didn't. It was too correct and was going to me. I'm a brilliant actor, as Jeanette. He was never better than a mediocre. Did I get rid of the competition? Did I kill him or not? You decide.
I simply don't know what to say. I certainly had no reason to off him. Well, I mean, we're the victim. He was always on time for rehearsals and always in his line.
I might have done it. It could have been revenge. You see, I was married to Gordon Forrest, but he ran out on me years ago. Got quite a shock when I turned up again. I enjoyed watching him squirm. Sweet revenge. Maybe it wasn't revenge. Maybe I did it to protect Audrey. Did I kill him or not? You decide.
I don't know nothing about nothing. Right now, I'd be home feeding the citizens my fish tank.
Looks like we have three strong motives to work with. Should I book Phil's Love, or should I book Audrey Thaxter, or should I book Paul Westerfield? You decide. I can't book them all. You can only stretch circumstantial evidence so far before it snaps back in your face. I think we should do some more investigating. What do you say? Yes or no?
No! Yeah!
Investigating it is.
Here's a material requested, Detective Woolrich.
Thanks, Garrett. I think you all know Officer Garrett.
We're not likely to forget that he was the first officer on the scene.
Scene of the crime, you mean?
Naturally.
Scene of the crime? Why quibble over words? We talked to him before we talked to you. What does it matter?
I thought this building was supposed to be sealed off.
Think he yelled tape on the doors?
Nah,
I'll have to use Google on it.
Building can be reopened. The department's got all the information it needs from the crime scene.
Such as?
Anything the coroner's office required. Forensics, DNA, evidence, bag, photographs taken of everything on stage. I take plenty of notes.
I recall.
It's so gruesome to think about. First we all thought Gordon choked to death and the wine went down the wrong way.
It's not unheard of.
Couldn't believe it when I heard it was poisoned.
And I can't imagine what new information anyone can give you, Detective Woolrich.
Purely routine.
We've already told you everything.
Several times.
Never can tell. Someone may have forgotten something.
Like what?
That's what I'm hoping to find out. We'll put that on the cop table, Garrett. Take a seat.
Yes, sir.
I appreciate everyone showing up.
What choice did we have?
Cops on my doorstep today.
Police pestering the neighbors.
Answering the same questions over and over.
Patience, ladies and gentlemen. Patience. I'll try to make this as painless as possible.
What are you?
It's an
occurrence. That's not funny, Dolly.
Neither is murder.
The coroner's initial report stated that Gordon Forrest was probably poisoned.
Probably? You mean he wasn't?
I mean the coroner was unable to identify the poison immediately.
Isn't that rather unusual?
Not if the poison is extremely rare.
Was it?
In this country, yes. This is a copy of the toxicology report. The poison that murdered Gordon Forrest is nearly always lethal. Once the toxin enters the bloodstream, death is almost instantaneous. A few seconds, that's all.
Obviously, you're suggesting that the prop wine, which was nothing but grape juice, was poisoned.
Am I?
How could it be the grape juice? We also do glass cork in the same decanter.
Perhaps the poison was in the glass Gordon Forrest used, not in the decanter.
I resent that. I handled all the props in the rehearsal. There was nothing in that glass.
Someone could have put something in when you weren't looking.
I tell you, the glass was empty.
I have an idea. What do you think? Shall we restage the murder and look for clues?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can we be serious this time?
Yes?
I'd like you to tell me again what happened the night of the murder. The rehearsal. Exactly as you remember it. Describe the set.
Oh, very well. It's viewers, sis.
We'd appreciate it.
We're rehearsing a play called Three Doors to Death. It's a murder mystery.
We assume that by the title.
The setting is a library in a large manor house on the English moors, early 1800s.
Uh-huh.
There are three doors leading to the room. One door leads into a small study, another door leads into a hallway that opens out onto the gardens, and another door leads into the main part of the house. A fireplace there, desk, wine decanter, and glasses on top. Armchair there. Everybody, please. I made a good rehearsal. You ready with the props, Barbara?
I've got most of them.
Would you like me to sweep the stage, Miss Marsh?
Not now, Dolly, if you don't mind.
I don't mind.
Can't you see we're rehearsing? The armchair don't belong that far out.
There. That's better.
Dolly, Three Doors to Death already has a stage manager.
I like to feel that I'm part of the team.
I'll let you know when you can sweep up.
I don't have to do this work, you know. I've got money.
Can we please get on with rehearsal? Begin. Ah ha ha, you're a witty fellow, George.
Am I?
You could just slap me on the moors. Ha ha ha.
If you say I'm witty on the moors, then I must be witty on the moors. One must be on the moors, one might as well be witty. Ha ha ha!
I say, back from the mall so soon, are we?
Hello, who's here? Harry.
Been here for that close to five. Oh, won't look out.
Don't mind if I do.
I think a glass of grape juice. Oh, sorry, Ned.
Never mind, Nick. Get on with it.
I think a glass of wine is called for.
I'll get your favorite wine glass, Uncle Harry.
Thank you, Cynthia.
Uncle Henry, I must show my friend from India to me as a gift. He's in the army now, Calcutta.
I say, that
That's a wicked-looking thing.
It's a blowgun. The native put a poison jar or poison needle with a hard point of breath. They spit it out, like this.
Not the proper sort of give, not the proper sort of thing to give young ladies. That's what I say. Glass of wine?
Here's your favorite wine glass, Uncle Harry.
Thank you, Cynthia.
Why should you have a particular wine glass this time? It's something I'll never understand.
That doesn't surprise me, idiot.
Allow me to fill your wine glass, Brother Harry.
Good, good. So far, good. Don't lose your British accents. Keep up the pacing.
Right.
Speak out loud and clear.
A toast to health, wealth, and good fortune.
To health, wealth, and good fortune.
Excellent bouquet. Excellent taste. Sweet without being sentimental.
Gordon, what's happening? What's wrong?
He's choking. Look at his face. He's turning blue.
He's falling. Gordon!
I'll take care of this.
How the police and Officer Gary showed up.
I came to the door approximately 10 minutes after 7. Thank you, Miss Marsh. You may be seated. Is that the way the rest of you remember it?
Yes, I think so.
I'm sure I didn't leave anything out.
That's exactly the way it happened.
In that case, I wonder why no one mentioned Dahlia Gray moving the armchair a little just before the rehearsal began.
Well, I didn't think that was important.
Everything about murder. I wonder too why no one mentioned how Gordon Ford reacted to Philip Lovely's blowgun.
You must suggest that he used a poison dart or poison needle. Hit him less with a twitch or an itch, obviously.
A dart is an excellent way to eject a poison, especially when it is propelled with considerable force. Do you have the blowgun, Garrett?
It's here.
Let him see it. Take a good look at it. Recognize it? Let them see it too. It's possible Dolly Gray placed a needle in the armchair pillow.
Hey!
Sit down, Miss Gray.
Is that how it's done? A needle in the armchair pillow?
Consider this. Phil's love and double opportunity.
How can you say that?
The blowgun and the fact you also fluffed up the pillow.
Oh dear, that's right. If you think I'm the guilty one, arrest me.
Don't say that!
You know you did to it!
Relax, Miss Love. It wasn't a needle or a dart. No mark on the body to indicate a point of entry. But the coroner found was a trace of poison on Gordon Forrest's tongue, also in the saliva. In short, the drinker sipped the poison.
I tell you, the glass I handed Audrey is empty.
But Audrey's actually turned her back before she made her entrance. She could have easily slipped something into the glass without you noticing, or even with the switch glass.
I hadn't thought of that.
Think about it.
What was the poison?
I was wondering if someone was going to ask. Garrett? What you're looking at is a pufferfish, also known as a balloon-figure toadfish. The deadly poison is contained in the glands.
No one would eat such a fish, would they?
In Japan, when properly cooked, glands removed, it's considered a delicacy. However, there's still a high mortality rate. The poison extracted from such a fish takes effect within seconds.
The pufferfish isn't native to these parts.
No, it isn't, but the fish club is awesome.
Fish collectors!
All right. I collect for an unusual fish. So what? Your neighbors, who have seen your aquariums, report you had a pufferfish.
It died. Besides, why would I want to kill Gordon Forrest?
I suppose you're accusing me again. I stand the prime suspect. After all, I do have a pet shop in control. It kills time and amuses me. I donate all the profits to charity. This playhouse couldn't continue without Phyllis's financial support. Rolled with the kittens and puppies, I'll also ran unusual fish, mostly tropical fish.
I bought all my tropical fish from Phyllis's shop. Most people in this town do.
If you must know, I did sell some fish to Dolly.
Charged me plenty too.
I didn't even get a discount.
Anyone could have gotten such a fish from a specialty store. If you're pardon the expression, we'll risk that you're just fishing.
Are we? What shall we hit him with? Motive, or a long discourse on the ninja fuel of Japan and how they prepare poison fish? I never get to do that discourse on the unusual fields of Japan and how they prepare poison fish. Well, if it's motive you want, it's motive you get. Let's see how they react when we tell them what we know.
Sit down, you two.
My team of investigators has turned up a lot of information on you people. Take you, Miss Love.
Must you be picking on poor Phyllis? It's harassment, that's what it is.
I'll get around to you in a moment, Mr. Westfield. What we found was an unmailed letter to you.
People like Brian here love slurpyburp. It helps them out a lot. It gives them back that natural energy that they need for a daily lifestyle. But the other drinks, come here, other drink. The other drinks, they get watered down, you see. They love profit. They go for the money. But Slurpyburp, we don't go for profit. It's 99% pure caffeine. That's what makes you get up in the morning. Gets you up and off to school in the mornings.
What's the other percent?
Well, good thing you should ask. The other percent's just some spam company and some,
tobacco.
And, that's pretty much the rest of it.
Cool.
Yeah. So when you need some help and you want to gain back some of that natural lifestyle you missed when you were young, go to your nearest Slurpyburp and buy yourself one today.
Just one will get you out of that bed.
Cheer up. Drink Slurpyburp.
You'd scream like a girl on that one, dude. Whoa.
Not again.
Yeah,
burned on that one.
Remember, you're watching Eliminate on WBP.
Mom already
knows
where my
$75 one. Casino, hello. Craps.
Once again, I got this one. I've always had a fantasy, and having two girls in a hot tub with a big bus. But here's what I'll say. Joy, you can stay. Lacey, you can stay.
Oh, thank you.
I guess my muscles are big enough.
I'm sorry. It's just a fantasy that I'm having.
I know.
Sorry. Okay, that one, because honestly, I'm too small.
I think Nick missed out a lot by telling. Evelyn?
What workout was that here?
Yeah, I know. Who would do that, Dad? Favorite channel.
No!
That's my girlfriend, Dad. Both of them.
The pillow ball?
Sure.
You're sashing, Mommy. It's not.
Never.
And then
for your corners, never. Carol DeVall. Squares, and you sew them together. And then you just sew all your rows and your sashing strips. Is that it, Dad?
Straightforward and very simple. Very simple.
What about orders?
Okay, but they need to be shown how.
Chris Marie.
And that's what, where there's a will, there's an A, is all of.
I hate that program. There's a will, there's an A.
See, dude.
Yee-haw!
Uh-oh, pickpocket. I need a tree like that in the back. Bamboo tree.
Boom.